26. I've been having a few conversations with Ms. Kavanagh and Mr. Rhodes, and they feel that you're absolutely the right people to take on an important challenge for the whole school, for our entire school community. We find ourselves in a situation where we need to redevelop all of our play and recreation areas across the campus, in particular across there in primary. So the challenge that I'm laying down to you is for you to go out to discuss with all of the various people who would be interested in this, other students, right the way down to your early years in Key Stage 1, with parents and with staff, to discuss with them what will make the best use of our recreation and play areas outside the primary school. That's a very important undertaking, and I don't want you to rush it, and you'll need lots of support from staff, but this is you leading at Year 6. You'll be the ones who'll gather all the information and come back and make recommendations to me and to the senior leadership team here at Bispushi, and our plans going forward for the primary recreation and play areas will be based very much on the work that you do and the information and the recommendations that you put together. So, it's an important job, but Ms. Kavanagh and Mr. Rhodes assure me that you're really up for this and that you're absolutely the right people to take this on as the senior pupils in our primary school. So, the very best of luck, and I look forward to meeting with your representatives to hear what you think we should be doing. Thank you.
Reflections of the fears I know I've left behind. I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending. I'm on my way. Can't stop me now. And you can.
Lots of cover for shade, rain and snow, lots of plants, safety, and the fun of the children. In the KS1 area, they want lots of climbing nets because they think that that's a good way for them to get out their energy, as well as lots of educational areas. Reading areas and drawing areas.
She'd like some painted things on the floor and a wooden gazebo with benches inside so children can sit in there and eat their snacks or maybe read.
So she'd like the idea of having a pirate ship and putting and moving the in the catering area, moving the flags onto the masts so the flags are higher.
And she thinks that everything has to be the equipment should be high but safe. In Key Stage 1, keep space for running area.
Most of the parents like the idea of a space for educational purposes. So areas where
reading areas
and areas where the teachers can take them outside and teach them about growing plants and planting vegetables and plants and flowers.
It's never too late to try. What have you done today to make you feel proud?
Thank you. What materials do you think are most suitable for the equipment around the playground?
I think the ground needs to be soft if you're going to have climbing equipment or anything like that. It depends on your ideas, really. Does that answer your question? You have to make sure that the materials are good, because we want, if we're going to create something new on the playground, we want it to last, don't we? Yeah. So I think we would try and get really good equipment so that it wouldn't cause any harm to the children.
One particular thing about the playground that you would like to change?
I think our playground is very big, but there's a lot of children out there, and I don't think there's very much for you guys to do sometimes other than play football. So I would like to see more shade, some more seating, and some equipment for you to play on. That's what I would say.
You could be so many people if you make that grab for freedom. What have you done today to make you feel proud?
What is this?
This is our plan for the
AUAFS.
What is that, a pirate ship?
Yeah,
it's tiny.
We first had to Santa Maria, but that didn't fit.
What problems have you faced?
First of all, we've had to scrabble our whole plan. The whole thing was too big, and then we had to
who's gonna be deciding what equipment to put where, like the spatial thing? Okay, so I'll do that. Hannah, Nicholas, what are you? What will you do? Okay, so you're drawing with Sophia.
Okay.
So everybody get a start.
We are thinking of putting some shade here with the tree.
Yeah,
and then go in. This is the sand pit. We're keeping it as a sand pit, but we're changing the outside instead of concrete, like this soft material.
Football. Okay, we don't need to put like a whole pit.
Yeah, I know.
Just poles and whatnot.
You could replace the running track with a football.
Yeah,
but it'd be too small.
Yeah, I know. No, we're not gonna make a field. We're just gonna put
poles. Yeah, football area.
And then they're like playing, but they don't need
to. I think we should put a field. Then have a long field over here. And then two goals over here.
And one field.
One field.
But think about how long that is.
It's not that long. What, 5 meters? What's the aerial runway for?
How are you gonna fit that all that in?
This is not that big. This is about this big. This is like this small. It's just like a normal swing for 3 people.
Well, it's gonna happen.
Oh, wait, tell us what the girls like. You're not telling us anything.
Well, the girls like no like forest themes, not ships.
What about the motor worker? That is.
That's a forest that, theme.
But
can't
the thing is, the motor worker is for boys and girls.
Yeah, exactly. So that's why we're using it.
Well, you guys turn back to the pirate ship.
Yeah,
exactly.
Let's check how big the pyramid is.
The pyramid is only 5 meters per.
You can fit that in easily.
Five.
Okay, so what type of bins do you think we should have?
We should maybe have a compost bin.
I think we should have the angry birds.
Because they're eating bananas. They can put the banana peels in the compost.
Animals.
There should be more bins because maybe dragon bins. Because they're banana peels everywhere.
And the compost.
It can be altered. It can exactly be there. Because lab sync implements alter it for different schools. They want a different kind of design.
What? It's true. One plus all one plus. Then we know that.
Okay, then we can go.
Well, what you do, you would put them in, that depends. If you're going to move the flagpoles, that's great. But even if you don't move the flagpoles, you're still okay. And you would just put that's a good idea to put the swings over by a fence. You don't want to put swings in the middle. So that's a good idea. And you could do that bird's nest plus four, like that. You could do that. And he came out to about there, that's correct. And that still leaves a lot of space here to go on and make other things.
Yeah, so our school is here, the playground is here.
And there's already some play equipment right here, isn't there?
Yes, I know, but we're going to break that down.
Yeah. Yeah. And that fence is going to stay, isn't it?
Yeah.
And then the next one over is the, that's, right. Yeah, so we're talking this, there's a running track here, correct? Was there?
Yeah, but there's an entrance here, actually.
Yeah. But there is a running track, isn't there, I think? Let me check my...
Yeah, there is. We're planning to just take it out.
Okay,
so.
Taking everything out and then starting
over. Yeah, because that's what our teacher said that we should do, because the running track isn't used so much, so we're just taking it out to replace with those two.
Yeah.
Realize that to question is how we grow. To question is to grow. So I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending. I'm on my way. Can't stop me now. You can do the same. Yeah. What
CBL process, I learned to work as a team and never give up.